time watching, subscribe, like the video because it's awesome. Watch my other videos because they are epic.
There's evidence that Tony Stewart may have actually killed fellow race car driver on the track. Ontario County, New York, NASCAR driver Tony Stewart hit and killed another driver who was walking on a track during a dirt track race in upstate New York, authorities said early Sunday. Kevin Ward Jr., 20, died from injuries suffered in the incident, which occurred Saturday night at the Empire Superior Sprint Series event at the Canandaigua Motorsports Park. I can't even begin to pronounce that word. The track is about a two-hour drive from a Watkins Glen International racetrack where Stewart had been scheduled to race in a NASCAR event Sunday. Quote, there aren't words to describe the sadness I feel about the accident that took the life of Kevin Ward Jr., Stewart said Sunday, according to a written statement tweeted by NASCAR. It's a very emotional time for all involved. My thoughts and prayers are with his family, friends, and everyone affected by this tragedy. Stewart's team, director Greg Zappadelli, said Sunday morning the driver had decided not to drive in the event. Our hearts go out to Kevin's family, Zappadelli said. This is a very tough, very emotional time for everybody, his family, our family at Stewart-Haas Racing. On Saturday night, Ward's sprint car hit the outside wall during lap 14 of a 25-lap race, Ontario County Sheriff Philip C. Povero said. A video of the incident, I'm not going to show the video, I'm sorry, shows two cars coming out of a turn with Stewart's number 14 car sliding up the track towards Ward's number 13 car. The two cars get close and appear to make contact before Ward's car hits the walls and spins out. Another car narrowly avoids hitting the 13 car as it sits on the track facing the wrong direction. Ward gets out of his crashed car, walking on the track towards the race cars, which has slowed for a yellow flag. Ward points a finger and appears to be yelling. One car swerved to avoid Ward on the half-mile dirt track. Stewart's car passes close to Ward, and it appears that its right rear tire hits him. An ambulance took Ward to a hospital, but he died before it arrived, Povero told reporters. Stewart has fully cooperated with an investigation, Povero said. He acknowledges the collision with the driver. Povero said it appeared to an on-track incident. But I want to make it very clear there are no criminal charges pending at this time, he said. Ward from Port Layton was in his fifth season in the Empire Super Sprint Series. He began racing with his four-year-old's running go-kart event. Stewart spokesman said they are trying to sort out the details. Quote, a tragic accident took place last night during a sprint car race in which Tony Stewart was participating, Mike Arning said. Tony was unhurt, but a fellow competitor lost his life. Our thoughts and prayers go out to his family and friends. A competitor, which runs the car that swerved around Ward, expressed sympathy. Our deepest condolences go to the entire Ward family. We are one huge ESS family. You will be truly missed, bud. RIP 13, or hashtag RIP 13, Hebbing Racing tweeted. Stewart is a three-time champion in NASCAR top division and also won a sprint car championship in 1995. How old were all of you in 1995? Quote, our thoughts and prayers go out to the family, friends, and fellow competitors, and Kevin Ward Jr. NASCAR said in a written statement Sunday, we support Tony Stewart's decision to miss today's race, and we will continue to respect the process and timelines of the local authorities, and will continue to monitor this situation moving forward. Reagan Smith will replace Stewart on Sunday, Zappadelli said. Stewart also owns a dirt racetrack in New Weston, Ohio, and has frequently raced sprint cars during the NASCAR season. He broke a leg last year in a crash that ended his racing season. He has raced the full NASCAR season this year, but only returned to sprint cars in July. Now, I'm going to read you a comment that appeared on one of the stories, on one of the local news broadcasts. I'm going to leave the name out. I'm not going to read the name. Tony Stewart is a thug. He is always involved in accidents, and now he has killed someone. The fact is, never tried to slow down or swerve. Let me edit that for you. The fact is, he never tried to slow down or swerve. In fact, he hit the gas when he was close. I honestly think he tried to brush into the guy and flat out kill the guy. I hope he goes to jail for manslaughter, never races again, and loses big time in a civil lawsuit. For those of you who remotely think it was a complete accident, he knew there was a wrecked car on the track, thus slow down. There was a yellow flag out, thus slow down. Service crew would be on the track to attend to the wrecked car he helped cause, thus slow down. He's a professional, he knows better. But this thug, like anger, killed a guy, period. Go to hell, evil Stewart. And there were also allegations that Kevin Ward Jr. Was a hothead, a meathead, or I don't want to say evil, but he was supposedly, he had an attitude about him, and that Stewart didn't like his attitude, and that there was maybe a motivation to actually kill him. I'm not going to show the footage. This was brought to me by one of my subscribers and friends and one of my promoters. Looking around, the raw footage is really raw. So I have it at my fingertips. You can see the raw footage, and it appears that he speeds up, not slows down, when he gets close to Kevin Ward Jr. So, but this isn't an ordinary, this isn't a street, public street. It's not public cars. So they're going to give the benefit of the doubt that it was, in fact, an accident. So they're not going to press charges. This is a regulated sport. They're not going to press charges if, after their investigation, they do find something out. I mean, this is kind of hard to prove. So you're dealing with truly innocent before guilty, right? What do you think if you've seen the video? I'm not going to show the video. I didn't even want to watch the video because I am very sensitive to violence and human pain. I'm not going to show the video. YouTube doesn't want the video out. YouTube is flagging people's videos just for showing it. I'm not going to show it. Do you think there is possibly a conspiracy to kill Kevin Ward Jr. by Tony Stewart? I'm just asking a question. Don't sue me. Thank you for watching the Shikama Live Show.